Well, hey, beautiful friends, and if you're new, welcome to my channel. My name is Lady Cinnamon, and I'm excited because today I'm participating in collab where we're going to be getting ready for the Super Bowl with charcuterie boards. My gracious co-host is Gigi Faison for the Love of Decor, and guys, she has a great channel where she does design, she does DIYs, she also does fashion, cooking, you name it. Her channel is such an inspiration, and she's such a beautiful person inside and out, so you got to go by. Check out her channel. I'll leave a description bar below, and I'm sure you want to subscribe. So guys, we're doing charcuterie boards today. Normally, French tradition, it's cured meats and cheeses. I'm going to be doing the Italian version. My hubby is Italian, so we do tend to do a little bit more with the meats and the cheeses, but also it includes things like artichokes and antipasta and olives and vinegar that's in the vegetables. And guys, it's so delicious. So that's what we're going to do. So I have some cheeses. I'm going to be using Havarti cheese with dill from Trader Joe's. Also, I like to go with a sort of a firm cheese. So I'm going to be using the cheddar cheese with the caramelized onions. It's so delish. And also this blueberry and vanilla chèvre cheese. And it's pretty good. It's a soft cheese and it's a goat cheese. And I like to sort of mix it up with one that's firm, one that's a little soft and creamy, and then another one that's sort of in between. So I like to start off plating all of my charcuterie boards with the cheeses first. It is traditional, it's not something that you have to do. I'm just gonna cube these up for easy access. Next, I'm gonna be moving on to this cheese. And this Havarti is so delicious that it has the dill and the herbs already in it. For easy access, I'm just gonna go ahead and slice it up. I'm not going to put the whole thing on there like you would do with the brie or something. I'm just going to put the slices up there because this one is just for me and the hubby. And I'm just gonna go ahead and slice them so that way it'll be easily, accessible. Next, I'm gonna go ahead and add on that log, but that blueberry log, I'm gonna just put on the side for a half. Next, I'm moving on to my meats, which is the supersade, Italian salami. I usually go with the prosciutto, but this time I'm gonna go with one of these other meats that I'll show you in a little while. So this is a really great sausage that I have here. I'm gonna slice it thin. And guys, it smells amazing and it tastes amazing. And this is the super side. So what you want to do is you want to basically place these in between the cheeses on your board. You don't have to do that, I like to sort of do more of a traditional charcuterie board. Next, I'm going to go ahead and add in my Italian salami. And next, I have mozzarella. They didn't put a lot of the pistachio in this one, but this is such a good alternative for prosciutto, and I really wanted to mix mine up. So to make this look more appealing, I'm just going to double fold it down, and it'll give it a really great presentation, as you can see. Next, I'm going to go ahead and move on to some of my cold salads, which are antipasta also. I'm going to be using this feta cheese that already has sun-dried tomatoes and herbs in it, and it's delicious. Also, this olive medley that has Kalamata, Napoleon, it also has some blonde Malpighian, and also some green Hardiketi, and these are some really great blends for olives if you're interested. It already has its own brine and it's delicious. So to easily make this, I like no fuss and no muss when I'm entertaining, so that way I can get in on it also. I'm gonna add the feta to this to give it a really nice taste, and this is the easiest, quickest way when you're entertaining to hurry up and get done with your sides or any accoutrements or any antipasta. For my next, gonna be using these little sprinkle tomatoes, and I'm just gonna mix this with the same olives and the same cheese. So now I have four different cheeses, and I think that's pretty good for my charcuterie. Next, I'm going to be moving on to my accoutrements. I have a whole grain mustard, and you know I have to have the artichokes. You're not going to see one of these without artichokes when you're entertaining. Also, my accoutrements, I'm going to be using a really high-end blend. Instead of peanuts, I'm going to be using some really great candy pecans and some pistachios with some cranberries, and I got all this from Trader Joe's also. I love them. So guys, next I'm going to be moving on to my crudités, which are just raw veggies that you can serve with or without dips. Now for my crudités, no, those are not included. I just put those there for color. But moving on, I'm going to be going ahead and using some cucumbers, which I really love, that taste great with or without dip. And these really pretty sweet bell peppers that are red, yellow, and orange. Great color and great taste. Love those. Next, I'm going to be using some crunch that you always need. I'm going to be using some crackers for this, and I'm also going to use some cheese sticks. They are so delicious. I like to add these in for texture to give my board more variety and a great look. Also with my crunches, I do like to get artisan breads. You can pick this up from any bakery or your grocery store's bakery. This one is great. It has a really nice texture to it. When you get an artisan bread, you can still reheat it or toast it. So it's always nice to have that great blend with all of your textures and your bread. And this one is from Cranberry and Walnut, and guys, it's so amazingly delicious. It's also like a really nice rich flavor. So next is my fruit and sweet, and this component is also awesome. A lot of people use grapes. I'm gonna use strawberries. Now I know chocolate dipped strawberries are so 1990, but guys, they're delicious, so why not use them? So I'm gonna be using the semi-sweet dark chocolate to go with those strawberries so it's not too sweet. I'm just gonna dip them and place them onto some parchment paper so it does not stick and it's easy cleanup. For the top, I'm gonna go back with some white chocolate and just go over the top so it's two-toned, and then just drizzle that white chocolate over the dark chocolate to give it a really pretty look to it and a nice presentation. So they look absolutely fabulous, and I love the way everything turned out. I really wanted to create some really great, rich, complex flavors and components, and I really think I did a great job. So I hope you guys like my crudité, my charcuterie, and all of my other components that will go with it. And I think it turned out perfect. So guys, I hope you were able to get some really great ideas. Don't forget to check out all of the other participants on the playlist that I'll leave in the description bar below. And also don't forget to stop by my gracious co-host Gigi Faison for The Love of Decor for her great channel and some great inspiration. And all of that will be in the description bar below. Thank you all for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.